Hello everyone, I am Devanshu Kumar and today I will be discussing a problem named Evil Professor. This was a question of Code Chef December 2019 lunchtime. Okay, division 1. Okay, so yeah, I will write here division 1 itself. Okay, and then this was a pretty interesting question. So in this question, we were given that there is a string of length L. Okay, and then there is a string consisting of 0, 0, 1, 0 and 1. Okay, suppose let's say this string. And then a function is defined f of lr, okay, such that for each I belonging to I is less than equal to l and I is greater than equal to l and less than equal to r, the ith bit is flipped. Flip ith bit. Okay, and then this function is defined as how many pairs are there such that in the resulting string, let's call it u. Okay, ui is equal to ui plus 1. How many pairs of these? How many such pairs are there? Count. Okay, I will just write it clearly. Okay. Just erase it. I will write it again. Okay, I didn't write it clearly. Okay, count of how many ui is equal to ui plus 1. How many pairs are there such that this, after flipping, u equal to resultant string after flipping each I for I is greater than equal to L and less than equal to R. Then f of LR is defined this. Then we have to find the value of summation of f of LR for each L and for each R, such that let's just say L equal to I to N, 0 to N, then r equal to n minus 1, let's just say, and r equal to l plus 1, l to n minus 1. Okay, I will just write again l. So basically you have to find this value, okay, this summation value, and we have to output this, right? So what I mean by this is, let's just say, I will give you a small example considering LR. So let's just say L was 1 and R was 2 in for this string. Then after flipping this string value, so means from 1 to 2 each value will be flipped, right? So we will have 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. And then how many pairs are equal? That is nothing but first pair, second pair, and yeah, that's all. So the f of 1 comma 2 will be nothing but 2, right? And so summation of this whole summation is nothing but like this, something like this: f of 1 comma 1 plus f of 1 comma 2 plus f of 1 comma 3 plus f of 1 comma 4. Let's just consider the string is of length 4 for now. Then plus f of 2 comma 2 plus f of 3 comma 3 plus f of 4 comma 4, 3 comma 4, and plus f of, here it should be 2, I guess. Yeah, I meant wrote it wrong. Okay, it should be 2 comma 3, and then here it should be 2 comma 4, here it should be 3 comma 3, and here it should be 3 comma 4, and then plus f of 4 comma 4. So basically for each L, how many R I can go? These values, all these values we need to find. Okay, so a brute force approach would be to just flip each of these ranges and find how many pairs are there. So basically if I am just running a loop for let's just say for L, then I am running a loop for L, and then I am count, and then I am flipping this bits. Okay, so flip bits, let me call it. Okay, and then I'm counting the number of pairs. Okay, how many pairs I have, right? Then if you see this, this is nothing but this is n times, this is n times, and flip bits will also take n and counting the number of operations. So basically this is n cube operation, because in this loop you can perform two things. So a brute force will have n cube solution, which will definitely not pass. Okay, so you need to come up with something better, something optimized. Okay, so first thing you can see is when I'm calculating any yeah, and this was all of the problem. Yet if you have not solved this question, I would suggest to pause the video now and try to solve this question. Okay, else now I will start discussing the solution. Okay, so if you see this problem carefully, let me just say there is a string 1011. Okay, now let me just say I flip the second bit. Okay, that is nothing but 2,2. Okay, so I flip this bit. So do I need to calculate the full sum again? Means like, do I need to iterate over the string to find how many changes did I make to by just flipping one bit? Or if you see carefully, if I just flip this one bit, how many places can it affect? One pairs and two pairs. So basically, if you see, if I just count the initial value, okay, so here I have only one pair, okay, then if I just flip 2,2, let me just say 2,2 I flipped, okay, then I can just see whether this value, this 2,2, is it equal to the previous one. If it is, then let me just say this is equal to x. Okay, so the answer will be x plus 1. Okay, because if it is same, then I added another pair, right? One more pair I was added, because earlier it was 0, then obviously if they are same now, earlier they would be different. Okay, again similarly here, if I will check, if again they are same, then I added one more pair, right? So that, so the answer here will be nothing but x plus 1 plus 1, that is here 2, x was here 1, right? So 1 plus 2 is 3. Okay, so let me just count it, 1, 2 and 3, yeah, right? So I have 3 pairs. Let me just consider another example. Okay, let me just say here it was 0, 0, 1. Now let me just say again I flipped this, here the x value is nothing but 1 and 2, so x equal to 2, earlier value, right? Now if I flip this bit again, okay, so if let me just say I will flip this bit again, so I will have 0, 1, 0, 1. So if I flip this bit, how many pairs did it affect? Okay, since the previous one is not same, so basically what I mean that, if the after flipping the bit, if the previous pair is not same, means earlier it was same and you destroyed one pair, so you should subtract one. Okay, and similarly here, if you'll see again it is not same, then again you destroyed a pair, then you must subtract -1. So here it will be x -1 -1, that is here it should be 0. Let me just check here. So you'll have, yeah, 0 pairs you have, no consecutive elements. So basically you can deduce one simple conclusion is that fact one, let me just call it fact one, if I flip one bit, flip ith bit, then if I s of, let me just say s of I equal to s of I plus 1, then I will have x plus 1, and else I will have x minus 1, and if s of I is equal to s of I plus 1, then again I will have x plus plus, let me just call it plus plus and here minus minus, it will be easier, right? I will just use shorthand operator or x minus minus. Okay, so basically this, so I don't need to iterate the full string to find the changes done by single bit. Okay, like this I will have the final answer ready with me if I just flip the one bit. This is fact one. Okay, how many facts I will deduce, that I will be using to solve the problem. Okay, fact one. Now let me just go to fact two. Okay, so let me just say, if you want to update 1 to n, okay, so you first flipped first bit, then you got how many pairs, like, okay. So, and then let me just say you wanted to calculate 1, 2, 3, okay. Then that is nothing but 1, 2, 3 is nothing but flipping first bit and flipping 2 to 3, okay. And then this 2 to 3 can be again written as 2, 2 plus this flipping of 3, 3. So that is nothing but I can go on flipping 1, 1 bit from 1 to n, then I can get the value of 1, n. Okay, at each value I can get this iteration. So let me just give an example for easier understanding. Let me just say the string was of length 4 and I have this string 0011. Okay, so here x was 2. Okay, you have two pairs. Okay, and then let's just say 1, 1 I had. Okay, so after 1, 1 this will become 1, 0 and 1, 1. So using our previous formula also, if I'm flipping ith bit, okay, if it is equal, not equal to the next one, obviously the answer will be x minus 1. So x dash, I will call it x dash, or let me just call it x1. Okay, x1 equal to x minus 1, that is nothing but 1. Okay, so I got here 1. Okay, and you can see also it is 1. Okay, then let me just say I operated 2, 2 on this string. So that will be nothing but operating 1, 2. So because you flipped the first bit already, so when you are flipping the second bit, actually you are doing flipping of 2 bits. Okay, and then if you see here, so I have flipped this bit and it is equal to the two neighboring places. So obviously x2 will be nothing but x1 plus 2 because you added two pairs, right? So 1 plus 2 is again 3. You can count also, I'll have 1, 2 and 3 pairs. Okay, so and similarly if I go with again, if I operate 3, 3 on this string, okay, so that means this position will be flipped. Okay, so and then I will have x3 equal to nothing but x2, because since it is different from the neighbors, so you deleted two pairs, right? So you'll have only one, right? 3 minus 2 is 1, right? So you'll have, yeah, you can see there is only one. Similarly, if I operate 4, 4 on this, okay, I will have 1, 1, 0, 0, and then if you can see it is equal to the neighboring one, so but only one neighbor it is equal, so x4 will be nothing but x3 plus 1, so that is nothing but 1 plus 1 is 2. Okay, so you see this, I just applied 1, 1 operation at each time and I can have 1, n. How I can have 1, n? Let me just demonstrate you why I got 1, n. Okay, so let me just say I will use a different color here so it for easier understanding. Let this same string, let me just say now f was 1, 4. Okay, so 1, 4, so means each of the bit should be flipped. So here I will get 1, 1, 0, 0. So how many pairs do I have? 1, 2. So they should be equal to 2. Okay, f 1, 4. Now if you see, if I apply this continuous operation after this and then this, then this, then I am getting the final answer as 2, which is nothing but the same value and the string is also same. You can cross check yourself, right? So basically in this order I can so the fact too is if I need to go from 1 to n, I can just apply continuous operation for each of I comma I, right? This is fact 2. This is again essential, later we'll see how. Okay, so for n there is one last fact which you need to find. Okay, fact 3. Okay, so if you see, for let me just say for a string of length 4, I wrote earlier, right, we have pairs 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 4 and 2, 2, 2, 2, 3 and 2, 2, 4. Similarly 3 to 4, yeah, right, and here 4 to 4. So if you see this pattern here, this is nothing but 1 to n Okay, and then this is not this series. Okay, and if you consider this series is nothing but 1 to n minus 1 comma 1, means like I remove the 1 comma 1 pair, these count I removed because see this is empty, right? And then this is, and you didn't flip the first bit here. If what if I don't flip the first bit? So number of pairs which will be replaced, number of pairs affected if I don't flip I minus one, let me just say, okay, into n minus I. Because if you see here, this is nothing but 4 minus I times you must remove here this what started with 1 comma 3. Now if you want it to start with 2 comma 3, you should remove the effect of flipping of 1. Okay, means like the first bit. Okay, so this series. And then again, if you consider this series is nothing but this, suppose let's just say this was previous value. Okay, and then this is nothing but previous minus 2 comma 2 and minus again this part. Okay, let me just call it M, capital M. This part is capital M, let's just say. Okay, and then again if you see here, if this was next previous, then you are subtracting this. So you can see a pattern here. So means basically if I just find 1 comma n and go on subtracting a value, I can get it for 2 to n, and then similarly for 3 to n, then similarly for 4 to n and so on, right? So basically I don't need to iterate again and again. If I just find 1 to n, I can just subtract a value and then get the next answer easily. Okay, so yeah, these were the all facts which you need to come up with, right? So maybe you could have done it in a simpler way, I am not sure, but this was how I came up with the solutions, right? And then you have to just finalize the answer, right? So I will go to the code and explain it easily. Okay, so I just maintain the count array. Okay, this is nothing but 3 into 10 10 raised to power 5 or 6, okay, whatever was given, and we have a string s. Okay, and I have answer equal to 0 and equal to s dot length, and then for each I'm checking in the original string what is the initial value. This is nothing but x initial. Okay, how many initial pairs I have in the original string, that is nothing but x. Okay, and then for I equal to 0 to n, I'm taking count of I equal to x. Count of I is nothing but count of by what I mean by count of I is what if I flip 1 comma 1, what if I flip 2 comma 2, what if I flip 3 comma 3, and so on. So basically count of I denotes how many pairs will be affected. Okay, how many pairs will the string have if I flip just one bit. Okay, so as you can see earlier, so if I'm flipping one bit, then if you can see, if I minus 1 is greater than 0, means like if it has a neighbor to its left, if it is equal, then it should subtract, because after the flipping it will not be equal. Else it should add a pair, means if they are unequal before the flipping, after flipping they will be equal. What I mean by that is if it is 0 0 and if I flip the bit, it will be 0 1. So basically I will lose a pair, that's why count of I minus minus. Else I will add a pair. Okay, and similarly for I plus 1 less than n, if I have a right pair, right neighbor, so similarly same concept. Okay, so yeah, and then you will have for each of the I values, what is the number of pairs I can get. Okay, why this is useful? Because in fact 3, you can see I need to subtract 1 comma 1, I need to subtract 2 comma 2. So this is nothing but count of 1, then count of 2, then count of 3. So that's why that is the count value. Okay, I will remove these parts so as I can explain other things here again. Okay, so that is done. And then you have here, and then basically I'm iterating from 1 to n, 1 to n. Okay, and then I'm just flipping ith bit, okay, and I'm checking. Now b of I initially value of b is x, that is nothing but the initial value, how many pairs initially I have, and then I'm just flipping the bits and I'm checking whether they are equal, then I will add a pair, else I will subtract a pair, because as you can see in fact one here, you can see if they were not equal, then I must subtract a pair, right? So this is only what I'm doing here, okay? So, and then similarly for the right neighbor, this is for right neighbor and this is for left neighbor. Okay, my pen is not working properly. Okay, left and right, okay. And then answer plus equal to b, because for 1 to n it is sum of 1 comma 1 plus 1 comma 2, right? So all till 1 to n, okay. So and then I'm not updating the b value, because you can see here, as you remember in fact 2, if I go to fact 2, this is the container sum, so means x2 depends on x1, not the original x, okay. So that's why then b here, if you see here b is remaining to the final value, so means if I get here b equal to x1 will be the final value, then b equal to x2 will be the final value, and then I'm updating on b, I'm not updating on the original x, okay. So I'll have x1 x2 like this stored in b at each of the iteration, and then I'm just storing the answer. Now the previous answer is answer, now the previous value is equal to answer. Now why I'm storing this here previous, now this was part of fact 2, okay, this part is fact 2, this part is fact 1, okay, and this one is again fact 3, okay, and this one is fact 3. If now I'm going from 2 to n minus 1, okay, so why 1, because like I use zero base index, that's why here you can see I'm going from 0 to n minus 1, so here I will go from 1 to n minus 1. Now if you see in fact 3, I found this 1 to n, now I need to find 2 to n, 3 to n and 4 to n, similarly like this, right, these parts. So these value I'm finding here, if you can see here the previous value is used, previous equal to previous of count of j minus 1, that is nothing but I'm subtracting 1 comma 1, 2 comma 2 or 3 comma 3 like this, okay, I'm subtracting these value here, okay, yeah, right. And then what I'm checking is, okay, if the adjacent pair is equal, so means I will there were, now I need to check how many pairs were the I minus 1 bit affecting j minus 1 here, because j is used here. So you can see, because if you remember here, I should remove the effect of 1 here, 1 1, and when I go from this step to this step, I should remove the effect of 2 here and 2 here. So if I remove the effect of 2 here, that will be nothing but 3 comma 3. If I remove the effect of 2 here, it will be nothing but 3 comma 4. So that's why you must remove the effect of j minus 1, okay. If the pair was equal, then I will add u plus plus, else u minus minus, okay. And then if j minus 2 is greater than equal to 0, means like ith bit, if 2, if I have here j here and then this is j minus 1, then I have j minus 2. So what is the effect of not flipping this I value? So that is nothing but how many pairs can I make from this, that is nothing but j minus 2 and j itself. So that's why j and j minus 2, if s of j minus 1 equal to j minus 2, because j, s of j will be flipped, that's why the condition is reverse here. I'm not flipping the bits, but I'm just calculating like if they are same now, right? So after the flipping also, after flipping they will be different. So if you can see, I am subtracting this value, right? So that's why it is plus plus here, and if they are same, then I must subtract one value similarly, and then I will have just previous equal to previous minus n minus j into u. In the fact 3, you can see number of effective pairs into n minus I, because I have here three pairs, 1 2 3, 1 2 and 3, so that is nothing but n minus I. So here I am just multiplying it by n minus j into u is how many pairs will get affected. U is nothing but how many pairs will it get affected, okay? And then answer equal to answer plus previous, right? And the previous value is getting updated each time, so I will have previous 1, previous 2, previous 3 like this. And then again for next computation, for 3 to n, I will use the values obtained from 2 to n. So I will just remove the count of 2 to, right? Here I am removing 2 to again. And this will go on till n comma n I obtain. And each time I'm adding the answer, and then I'm finally outputting the answer. Yeah, that was all. So yes, this was a quite long question. More facts were involved, more deductions were involved. So if you have doubts, do mention them in the comment section below. I tried to explain it nicely, but if you still have doubts, do mention them in the comment section below. Okay. And just to go over these three facts were very essential to solve this question. So if you didn't come up with these three facts, then your solution would be of n cube, which is not likely to pass. This present solution is order of n because you can see like each loop iterates at max to n. So this solution is order of n. Okay. And yeah, that was all. If you have any doubts, do mention them in the comment section below. Do subscribe to my channel and happy coding. Thank you. That's all. Thank you.